Welcome all in our online class. On behalf of St. Gregory's High School and College, here I am Johnny Shaha, Senior Teacher, Department of English. This class is for the students of class 5 and my subject is English second paper. Boys, hope you all are well by the grace of Almighty and you are doing well in your home. So, we are giving so many classes and I think you are watching these classes very carefully and attentively. Today, I restart my class with the solution of HW of my previous class. So, I had given you an HW. I will show you now the answer of that HW. So, keep your HW copy and match with my answer. If you find the answers are correct, then put a tick mark. And if you find the answers are wrong, so give a cross mark and write down the correct answer beside this answer. Okay, so now take your HW copy. We will start now. Our question number one was classification of sentence. So I am showing you the answers. Sentence number one, they work for the society. It is an assertive sentence. Question number two, go with them. Look very carefully. The sentence was started with a verb. Go is a verb. For that reason, it is an imperative sentence. Sentence number three, is he a good student? Look, there is an interrogative mark at the last of the sentence, the question mark. So, for this reason, it is an interrogative sentence. Sentence number four, what a funny boy he is. Similar with sentence number three, there is an interjection mark at the last of this sentence. For this reason, it is an exclamatory sentence. Sentence number five, may you live long. Here we find a wish, a prayer for someone. For this reason, it is an optative sentence. Now, answer the question number two. It was the parts of sentence. That means I asked you to write down the subject and predicate of those sentences. I will show you now the how you will write in your exam halls or in your CW copy or HW copy. So, this is the way. You should make a chart like this way and make two columns, one for subject and another for predicate. You may know the subject will be very little. For this reason, the column of subject is small. And the predicate, the column of predicate is bigger than the subject. In our first sentence, it was asked, they work for the society. So, they is the subject here and work for the society is the predicate. They is the subject and work for the society is the predicate. In sentence number two, it was an imperative sentence. For this reason, we know in imperative sentence, the subject will be you and it will be silent. So, here subject is you, it is silent, and the predicate is go with them. Sentence number three, the sentence was, is he a good student? Here he is a subject and is, comma, a good student are predicates. Look one thing very carefully that if we put any subject from the middle of the sentence, there we will use a comma instead of that subject. So, here I use that way. Is, comma, a good student. It is predicate. In sentence number four, the sentence was, what a funny boy he is. So, he is a subject. As we put he from the middle of the sentence, in that case, I use comma instead of he. So, what a funny boy, comma, is. These parts are predicate. Sentence number five, may you live long. So, the subject is you and may, comma, live long are predicates. Okay, boys? So, match with your HW copy. Now we'll move to our today's part. What is this? This is a sentence. Hooray, we have won the game. We may say this sentence as a speech. As a speech. And what are they? They are actually the parts of this sentence. So I think you may easily guess what topic we are going to discuss today. Is it? Yeah. Today we are going to discuss about parts of speech. Today we are going to discuss about parts of speech. I think you may know very well that there are 8 kinds of parts of speech. Noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. I will show you the easy way to find out the noun and some examples. Okay? Now take your CW copy. Keep beside your HW copy. Now take your CW copy. Copy this thing from parts of speech. Number one, noun. What is a noun? Name of any person, place, thing, or idea. That means any kind of name is called noun. I have given here example from person John, from place Bangladesh, from thing book, and from idea hope. So these all things are nouns. Number two, pronoun. What is pronoun? It replaces noun. That means the word we use instead of noun, that is called pronoun. Here I have given examples. I, we, they, you, it, he, she. These are pronouns. Now, number three, adjective. What is adjective? Adjective modifies noun or pronoun. Adjective modifies noun or pronoun. That means what kind of noun it is, how noun looks, how noun works. That means what is noun? It may be thin, it may be thick, it may be fat. Okay. This any kind of good or bad thing that modifies, these all things are adjective for noun or pronoun. So that means adjective modifies noun or pronoun. Number four, verb. Any kind of action or work. We may say that there is no sentence without verb. So to make a sentence, there must be present a verb. So verb is called the king of parts of speech. So any kind of work or action is called verb. Number five, adverb. It modifies verb or adjective or another adverb. So adverb is very qualified. So it can modify verb, it can modify adjective, or it can modify another adverb. So adverb modifies these three things. Number six, preposition. It shows the relationship of a noun or a pronoun with another word. That means you may see that there is a whiteboard beside me. Sorry. Yeah. After me. So where is the black whiteboard? The whiteboard is behind me. The whiteboard is behind me. For the reason, behind is a preposition. Behind is a preposition. So it shows the relationship of a noun with another word. So where I am before the whiteboard, and whiteboard is behind me. So examples are in, to, on, with, by, etc. These all are preposition. Number seven, conjunction. It joins or connects two words or ideas or phrase. That means if we use some word to connect or to add two words, that is called conjunction. Number eight, interjection. This is very simple to understand. that in interjection, the word which is interjection after that word, we will find this interjection mark. Okay, so what is interjection? A word or phrase that shows a strong emotion. Now copy all these things in your CW. Pause the video and copy this thing. We will show some practice work, because after this thing, if you make a practice, you may understand very easily. Okay, let's practice. And the question is, classify the underlined parts of speech. Classify the underlined parts of speech. Sentence number one, they are playing in the field. They are playing in the field. The words underlined are they, playing, and field. Sentence number two, oh, it is a very interesting game. Oh, it is a very interesting game. Here, underlined words are oh and very. Oh and very. Sentence number three, honesty is the best policy. Honesty is the best policy. Here, underlined words are honesty and best. Honesty and best. Sentence number four, the students are entering into the classroom. The students are entering into the classroom. The underlined word is into. Number five, Safi and Tomal are good friends. Safi and Tomal are good friends. The underlined word is and. The underlined word is and. So now I'm giving you 2 minutes to write down the answer of these words. So what kind of parts of speech they are. Okay, write down. You should pause the video to look the questions easily. Okay, now I'll show you the answer. Answer. Okay. In number one, the first word was they, it is a pronoun. They, it is a pronoun. Playing, it is a verb. Playing, it is a verb. Field, it is a noun. Field, it is a noun. In sentence number two, we find oh, it is an interjection. Oh, it is an interjection. Very, it is an adverb. Very, it is an adverb. Sentence number three, there was honesty. It is a noun. Honesty is a noun. Best is an adjective. Best is an adjective. Sentence number four, into, it is a preposition. Into, it is a preposition. Sentence number five, and, it is a conjunction. So and is a conjunction. You will write down in your exam hall or exam script this way. You write down answer of the question number one or something, whatever, and you will give the number of that question, write the word, give the equal sign, and then the what the answer is. So you will show and you will write down in your answer script this way. You don't need to copy all the questions in your at the time of your exam. You will write down only the word and what kind of parts of speech they are. You write the only that name. Okay, so this is for today. I'm leaving now, and I hope you will be well at home. And from the next week, Injam sir will take your class. Okay. Thank you for being with me, and keep yourself at home. Okay. Bye.